say, somebody loves me, answers my prayer. I love somebody, I know he cares. Somebody tells me not to repine. That somebody is Jesus and I know he's mine. Till the last round work is done, he will call us home. To the match he has prepared, nevermore to roam. We'll stand by the riverside, cares will pass away. And if never a pain to bear, what a happy day. Somebody loves me, answers my prayer. I love somebody, I know he cares. Somebody tells me not to repine. That somebody is Jesus and I know he's mine. Somebody loves me, answers my prayer. Jesus and I know he's mine. Somebody loves me, answers my prayer. I love somebody, I know he cares. Somebody tells me not to repine. That somebody's Jesus and I know he's mine. That somebody's Jesus and I know he's mine. He's mine, yes.
Where the Savior died, down where for cleansing from sin I cried. There to my heart was the blood applied. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. There was the blood applied. Glory to his name. I am so wondrously saved from sin. Jesus so sweetly abides within. There at the cross where he took me in. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. There to my heart was the blood applied. Glory to his name.
Thy poor soul at the Savior's feet. Plunge it today and be made complete.
It's all me.
Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Glory to his name.
There to my heart was the blood applied. To his name, glory to his name, to his name.
I'm sure glad we have one family and friends.
No, let me tell you what that is.
You five.
And I get to do it, what I'm doing, and I'm not thinking about where I'm at. And it just comes out, and then I lose my place because I'm just worshiping and I forget where I'm going.
Okay, well, we appreciate you for that.
We forgive you.
Thank you. Y'all have thrown me tomatoes.
We are the Masters Men Plus One. Now, the Masters Men Quartet, as some of y'all have seen on the trailer, started almost 20 years ago. That's four men singing together. Now, at the end of 2012, the other three, we had been singing together for 18 years. And the other three, our wives, stayed home alone quite a bit, and kids had grown and gone, and grandkids had come, and all that kind of stuff. My wife asked me what was my plans, and I said, the Lord hasn't told me to stop yet. And she said, well, I'm glad he has, because I enjoyed it by myself. Well, the thing is right now, because she, Caleb's wife, my son, she has allowed him to come with us. Joyce gets to spend quite a bit of time with our grandbabies now. So I'd like to spend some time with our grandbabies too. But, and that comes one of these days, if and when God tells me to stop singing and stay home, I will do that. But until that happens, I will continue to spread his word in song. Amen. How about help me make welcome my son, Caleb Smith. This lady standing beside me is not my mother. She happens to be my sister. Now, when you know, in a male quartet, some man's got to sing like a woman. And when all the other guys decided that they needed to stay home and all that, I decided I didn't want to try to find a man that could sing like a woman, because, as you know, sir, those are hard to find, especially ones that will admit it anyhow. But I knew that I knew a woman that could sing like a man, and that happened to be my sister. She does a wonderful job on the alto part. How about helping make Phoebe Smith and Jones? Yes, we've been told plenty of times that she carries us well. She does. And I will be the first to admit that. We have friends with us today that have decided to come. I sang in a group with a call witness out of Richards Memorial Methodist Church for probably 10 years. 15. Is that, huh? 15 years. And Bonnie and Tommy Johns were a part of that group, witness out of Richards Memorial, and they are here tonight. Give Bonnie and Tommy a thank you all for being here. Debbie Barker has known us. We've known each other for a long, long time, and she lives right across the street somewhere around here and decided to come tonight. Thank you, Debbie, for coming tonight, and this is your granddaughter that's with you tonight. Linda Carr is with us today. Linda Carr, over some part of the 18 years that the Masters Men Quartet was together, she was our booking agent and did a wonderful job keeping us on the road. And we thank you for doing that, and can't wait till you start doing it again. So Linda Carr is a wonderful lady. Thank y'all for being with us. We are the Masters Men Plus One. Now, I'm not going to say a lot. We're just going to do a whole lot of singing. Let's do this. Get that single mic thing. Years ago, when those kind of things... I haven't figured out whether when they did the single mic thing a long time ago, whether they just did it because they liked it or they did it because they could only afford one microphone. I don't know, but we like it to do that single microphone, and y'all listen to these songs. Y'all know all of these songs we're going to sing tonight, so just sing them with us, and we'll start with this one. I'll lay this microphone back.
Oh,
that Phoebe and I have sang together before in a group that was called the Smith Family Singers. Now, our father loves Southern gospel music. His brothers love Southern gospel music. So Dad decided when we got old enough, he was going to grow him a quartet, and that's what he did. Martha has found a picture of us that she took when we were at a singing school in 1972. Now, you figure out how many years ago that was that we were singing. I was 12, Phoebe was 15, our sister was 10. No, Phoebe.
I was almost 15. Yeah, so. Well, 10, 12, 14.
Yeah, something like that. And Dad was a young man then, too. So,
but
we're going to continue to sing. Just Over in the Glory Land. All right. We're in a hurry, so let's go. Enjoy this music. Sing with us, all right?
Oh.
Oh, we haven't heard it. We haven't heard it in that time.
He's putting us under pressure, moving us so fast. Y'all just help us hang in there a second, okay? And we don't know what's next, because he's switch-flopping on.
Well, just flip the page, you should be there. You there?
I'm here.
Okay. I'm telling you, God is so good to us.
In the good times and in the bad times, we need to thank him.
Amen. But he is so, so good to us. This is a beautiful song.
From up in heaven, one day I looked down, saw that the souls of men downward were bound. It made it so sad, he wanted a plan, that say they might be, that say they might be. After all, as if they'll God save his son, and to die that her soul might be won. Wasn't he good, so good to you and to me? Oh, yes.
God is so good to me.
So good to me.
Yes, he is good to me.
So good to me. God is so good, so good. He's so good to me. My life to me, I've got so much to thank.
And sometimes,
sometimes
while on this way
I need,
I stop and say, Lord, thank you for all you've done for me. And when
I reach
sweet heaven, shore,
Lord, please just let me kneel once more.
I've got
so much to thank him for. Whichever one comes first. Listen as Stevie delivers this message. I've come too far.
I used to love, have hope.
heartache is over. For I left it at Calvary, where my new life began.
I've come too far to look back.
Understand why.
cheer up my brother.
Thank you.
There is love like I have never known. If I wander from your pasture, Lord, lead me back into the fold. Gentle shepherd, great provider for everything dear to my soul. In your pasture there is manna for my hungry, thirsty
months. And I know that this place has the love of the Lord in it. I know that this place has a shepherd that wants to draw people to a saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. So, I say that to say this. If you do not have a church home, this is a good one right here. And if you're going somewhere, you stay there. But if you don't have a church home, I can guarantee you, by what I know and what I feel and the word that is preached from that pastor, this is a good place to be. Amen. One of these days, because I know Jesus Christ is my Savior, I'm going to the land of living. If Jesus comes first, I'm gone in the twinkling of an eye. But if he tarries, and I go by the graveside and they roll me out of here in an old 90-pound casket, to be absent from the body is to be present with Christ. The key is knowing him as your personal Savior. And I hope that you do tonight. I get the privilege of singing this song and delivering the message. I love this song. Come go with me to the land of living. I hope that you are.
There's a place of dazzling beauty no human eyes ever seen, with gates of pearl and streets paved with gold. It's the land of milk and honey. Oh, it's gorgeous, just a dream. It's the land of life. in this paradise of dreams. The Lamb will be the only light we'll need. It's soothing walls of jasper, built by God's own hand. It's a land of light beyond the crystal sea. It's a land of light where evening ends forever, where the stream of death
through the day. When we mess up, he's there to lift us up, get us back on the right path. Phoebe gets to share this message. Beautiful message. Listen to this song. I love this song. Trophy of His Grace.
If you had known me then, the way I was before, then you'd understand why I can't hold back the tears. Now my life is so different since I gave it to the Lord, and I want to give Him glory while I'm to face.
We've got one more song to sing tonight. We want to thank you very much for coming out in this weather and worshiping with us tonight. I told Pastor, I said, it doesn't matter if there's 5 people here, 500. We're going to worship the Lord tonight.
Amen.
Thank you for coming and thank you for being with us. I will tell you that on a little lighter note, that all three of us have full-time jobs. We do this mainly on Sundays, and they actually ask us to fill out a visitor's card when we return to our church. But Caleb works for Covenant Hospice. He's a computer nerd and does all things to fix their computers when those folks tear them up. So he works for Covenant Hospice. Phoebe is a bean counter for the University of West Florida. And that's what she does. She counts money and spends money and spends your money and has a wonderful time doing it. And I'm just an old car salesman, so I work at Milton Chevrolet across the river up there. But we love the Lord tonight. And just like I said before, when he tells us to stop, we'll stop. Because I miss my grandbabies. I'd love to be there with them tonight. But we have a message and song to bring to the congregations and or whatever. We sing at fairs. We do sing at fairs every now and then. We sing at festivals. We get, Pastor, it's funny. We get invited to the barbecue bash out there put on by the Knights of Columbus. What is it, Smoking in the Square? We get invited to that. And there's people all over the place out there that don't go to church and all that kind of stuff. But guess what? On that day, they hear the gospel in the song.
Amen.
So I grab every opportunity to do things like that so that we can share his message. You know, some people might not come to a sanctuary and hear preaching, but if they'll go out there and eat them some barbecue and we'll bust them in between the eyes with the love of Jesus. That you can count on. I love you tonight, and we thank you very much for your support. The money that you give does not go in our pockets. It goes to further what we do and take us to places that we might not have gone before. What we're doing right now is trying to build an in-home sound studio so that we don't have to spend $5,000 or $10,000 on a project. So that's mainly what your money will go to tonight. It's helping us try to finish that up and get it to where Caleb and I can, he's the computer guy, and I know what it's supposed to sound like, but getting it to mesh together is tough, I have found. But we're learning the programs, and we're getting the sound studio built up, but thank you very much. If you do not attend this church and would like us to come to sing at your church or your festival, we would love to do that. And just see Phoebe. She's got a whole bunch of cards that she'll give you. We're on Facebook, The Masters Men Plus One. That's our Facebook page. She likes to do her shopping at the truck stops, her Christmas shopping at the truck stop that we stop at when we're going long places. So you can see little stories about that, and
you can see my grandchildren on there. G-Baby 1 and G-Baby 2. How many do you have?
Three.
You have three.
I have three.
She's got some.
I have some on there, too.
Yeah, don't worry about hers. Just look at mine.
See, Eddie in his...
Don't talk about my stuff.
When we practice sometimes like that, Jim.
Don't do that.
And, you know, if you go on there, you'll see him practicing, you know, with his knees bare and fingers.
Don't be talking about the knees.
No, we just, you know, we have fun and we love the Lord. We worship when we practice.
I have to wear medical socks, so they're knee socks up to here, so, and then the short pants, you know, and my bedroom slippers. So?
Anyway, we just love the Lord, we just have a good time. So you'll have something to laugh about when you're...
Well, at least I say it is my feet instead of yours.
That's
so
true.
We love y'all. You don't know how much. You really don't. Phoebe and I have been doing this a long, long time. And we don't continue to do it for him. This last song that we're going to sing talks about loving God and loving each other. You know, the old Pharisees tried to trick Jesus all the time and getting him to answer their questions wrong. And they thought that they was going to grab him this one time and ask him, what is the greatest of the commandments? And Eddie's version says that he said, well, there's not just one, there's actually two.
And it's to love God and love your fellow man. And I believe that you cannot truly love your fellow man unless you truly love God. And I also believe that you cannot truly love God unless you truly love your fellow man. Now, I'm not necessarily talking about the people inside the four walls here, even though that could be challenging sometimes too. I'm talking about all of those folks that are out there that we meet every day. I had a challenging one yesterday that was rough, but the Lord saw me through it. He did. And it was tough. And even my little, I have a fella that sells cars with us that he's a, and I don't know any other way to say it, but he's a Jewish person. And he texted me this, emailed me after church this morning. He said, "I hope that you're okay." And I said, I am. But people are tough to love sometimes. But we're supposed to do that. That's what our calling is, to love them. If they see us all sour and everything, how in the world are they going to want what we have? Love God and love your fellow man. Listen to this beautiful song. And if you'll let us sing one more after that, we'll do it. But time's getting past us. But here, I'll start this soundtrack. Listen to the message of this song. I love this song. Beautiful song. First verse is talks in the New Testament when Jesus was at the Last Supper. Second verse talks about the day. Hallelujah. It's been good to be here tonight.
Love me, God. Bye.